We are here on the campus of Andrews University. They got a graduation going on, so shout out to all the graduates of Andrews University. But unfortunately, I'm here in Michigan, Berrien Springs, for a sad occasion. And unfortunately, the matriarch, one of the matriarchs of our family, my grandmother, we call her Grandma Edmead, passed away a couple of weeks ago. And we just had the funeral on yesterday. And so I just wanted to share a few points, because everybody goes through some moments where, you know, a loved one has passed, or there's something that might be getting you down or what have you. It's just a sad occasion, right? It could be anything. And one of the things that I understand about, you know, sad occasions is that, as you see here today, like, I just want you to be encouraged and understand that there will be sunshine after the storm. And if you were here just an hour or two ago, I'm talking about it was raining like crazy out here. Like, I'm talking about, we were gonna have some lunch or what have you outside, and we were like, well, I guess we're gonna cancel this, cancel that. And literally, like, less than an hour later, it has turned out to be one of the most beautiful days that I have seen since I've been out here, right? It's almost like most of the water has dried up. The clouds look beautiful. I mean, it's the white clouds, not the gray clouds, right? The sky, you can see the blue in the skies. It looks like a beautiful, sunny day, right? But all of that happened shortly after the storm. And so, you know, I understand that even though we're going through a funeral, if I could see the positive side of things, like, I'm just thinking about the fact that all of my family was able to come together. We've been able to hang and fellowship. Some of the family I haven't seen in over 10 years, right? And so unfortunately it was a sad occasion, but the sad occasion actually led to some glorious aspects, or some glorious things, allowed some glorious things to take place, which truthfully may not have taken place for another 10, 20 years if the sad occasion hadn't occurred. So I just want y'all to be encouraged and just understand, like, in spite of the fact that you're going through some difficult times, and trust me, I'm not just talking to you because I've been through difficult times, but no, there are difficult times that I go through even now. I just want you to be encouraged that while you might be experiencing death in some areas of your life, like, if you look at it from the proper context, if you handle the situation or the experience properly, what looked like death can bring life. And I also want to leave you all with this, right? I'm not going to take up all of your time, but I just want to leave you all with this, right? Two things. Family, and more and more and more as I'm getting older, I'm just understanding, you know, how valuable family is. And not everybody's family is the same. Everybody's family doesn't have to operate the same. Not everybody's family gets along, you know what I'm saying, all the time. And there are some families who get along like crazy. But whether your family gets along or not, you know, certain occasions show you the importance of family. There's family here that I haven't seen, some of them in maybe like 10 years, but it's just been good to see their face, to know that they're alive and that they're doing well, and that they're doing all they can with the little that they might have, man. And so I just want to encourage you, whatever family it is that you have, some of y'all have been out of touch with some of your family members maybe for quite some time. Listen, get back in touch with who you need to get back in touch with. Build those relationships or what have you. Why? Because especially when we talk about the Black community, right? We know that one of the struggles that we have is that we tend to have broken down families. And when you have weak family units or weak family structures, it affects your ability to communicate and to build relationships outside of that family unit, all right? So I want us to just be encouraged to make sure that we concentrate and focus on family. That's one thing that I'm going to be very intentional about as we go through the latter part of this 2016 year. And the last thing I want to leave y'all with, man, as I thought about my grandmother, as I thought about my grandfather, what's amazing is that I go to different churches or what have you to speak. And my grandparents, they were from St. Kitts and St. Thomas out there in the Virgin Islands. And when I literally go to speak at churches or what have you throughout the U.S., one of the things that has happened continuously, people are like, yo, we've heard that last name before. Do you have any relatives out there? Or are you related to somebody out in, like, the Virgin Islands? And I'm like, well, have you ever heard of James and Veronica Edmead? And they're like, yeah, you know, out there in the islands, they used to be watchmakers. Your grandfather used to be a pastor. He used to do so much for the community. He used to own his own radio show, what have you, etc. And it's just a blessing to understand that what my grandparents did is that they left a legacy. And what I want you all to do, and what I'm trying to do with my life, and not that I'm perfect, not that I'm some great human being or what have you, but I'm just trying to find small ways to leave a legacy, man. And I love it, and I'll end with this. Dr. Miles Monroe, I said this at the funeral, but one of my favorite quotes is from Dr. Miles Monroe. And he was talking about this verse. For those, some of y'all, if you're a Christian, you might not know the verse, but even if you're not Christian or if you're not religious, you can still get something from it. But there's this point where Jesus is talking to the disciples, and he tells the disciples, he's like, yo, it's better for you that I go away. And when you're talking about a leader, most of us think that leaders, like the mark of their leadership is that they have to be around, they should be there in person in the flesh. And it was crazy that Jesus was telling them, like, nah, look, we're gonna see how good my leadership is by seeing what it's like when I leave, right? And so when I think about my family members, when I think about my grandparents who passed away, the amazing thing to me is that they left a legacy of leadership, because even though both of my grandparents on my father's side and one of my grandparents on my mother's side are gone now, the legacy that they've left is a testament to the leadership and the great leadership that they had. Because when I look at their sons, when I look at their daughters, when I look at the grandchildren, and when I look at the great-grandchildren, I see how we have picked up right where they left off, right? And like I said, again, this is not a call for you to think that you gotta be perfect or what have you. But what I've learned from my grandparents and the legacy that they left is that even if what you have inside your hands is just something small and something little, it's more than enough to do something amazing with, man. So that's all I'm trying to do here. I can speak, so I'm using my voice to speak. We got cameras, so we're using cameras. Use whatever it is that you have to begin leaving the legacy. Make your family proud, make your friends proud, make your community proud, and do all you can to pour back into others, man. So this is Coach Vaughn. We just did a little retro kind of thing once again. Shout out to my brother Justin, shout out to the rest of my family, and shout out to all of y'all who continue to watch in. I hope that this helps you. I hope that this blesses you. Peace out.